some volcanic rock dust. And some of you may have seen, you can buy this stuff, it's quite expensive, make about £20 for 20 kilograms. But if you get a large amount, like a ton, it's cheaper than a ton of fertilizer, but it's still expensive. But it's not really a new thing. Elliot Coleman, in a wonderful book he wrote 30 years ago, was advocating its use on soil for vegetables. And so I got some. I only got it last year, so I can't honestly say it's made any great deal of difference yet, but I'm fully expecting that it will sustain the soil over a long period of time. And then we come to the good old horse manure. Now, horse manure's amazing stuff. It does unfortunately have seeds in it. So unlike cow manure, I think cow manure is probably better, although some people say pig manure is even better than that, but there you go. So that's horse manure. And sad man that I am, I spent 4 days collecting 240 bags from somebody who was kind enough to let me have it in Arran. And but in the ground next to the horse manure, I was a big hole because someone had been in with a tractor and it was full of black liquid. And I went and sifted the liquid and put it in containers. And I'm going to use this as a supplement. And not only that, another picture will show you that I've been collecting all the wood ash. We have big fires here because there are lots of rhododendrons outside. And I collect all the wood ash before the rain takes into the soil by means of a metal dustbin. And then I sift this wood ash, and the stuff that's in the sieve is unburnt wood, and I smash that up with a rock. And I think I'm creating a variation of what's called biochar, and biochar is another hot gardening thing at the moment. And I see that DT Browns are now selling bags of it at an enormous cost. So I've created my own biochar from wood ash. The wood ash, of course, is very useful, especially in a place like Arran, because our soil's quite acidic, and wood ash, apart from giving a lot of potassium, or is it phosphate? I get them boom mixed up, but anyway, actually is quite alkaline, so it's good. So I'm going to now use my biochar and mix that with the black liquid, and that's called charging the biochar. And that means the biochar is like a form of carbon, and it's full of holes, and it will take in that liquid and it will release it slowly into the soil. And so yeah, that's about it. Then I've planted, interplanted garlic with strawberries. What I learned in here last year, if you put strawberries very close together, then they just get infections. It's a bit like putting fish in a cage altogether, or people in beds in hospitals close together. It's not good for them. So you have to separate them. I've learned that to my cost. This is Mange Tous. I love Mange Tous. That's the little pod that you eat before the peas develop. I think you'll agree these are looking quite healthy. In this bed, I've got a thing here called Celtuce, which is new. It's spelled C-E-L-T-U-C-E. And it's supposed to be a cross between celery and lettuce. This turnip has, if you like, sort of gone to seed. There was a turnip here, but now it's just producing leaves. But these leaves are actually very delicious, and they make good sort of spinachy stuff. This is a Petrowski turnip. And then over here, coriander. And I cut the coriander right back, and it's come back up with more coriander, so that's really good, and that's calabrese. I'm probably planting all the wrong things at the wrong times in the wrong places, but guess what? Sometimes the books aren't right, and sometimes you get a surprise. And I think one of the important things about gardening is experiment. You ask 10 gardeners for an answer to a problem, guess what? You get 10 answers. Come up with your own ideas, think about things, and you learn from your mistakes. I've certainly learned from mine.